Hello guys, and welcome back after a very long time here at Architects3DP. Today we're going to review a set of really cool devices provided by ATOMSTACK. As you may have recognized from the intro, the main star here is the ATOMSTACK Maker A30 PRO, which is complemented with a silent air pump, the high-quality ATOMSTACK Maker R1 rotary jack, and also the R2 roller. And finally, their newest ATOMSTACK Maker AC1 camera. You will find the links to buy all these amazing products from ATOMSTACK down in the description of the video. Okay, so the three products came inside different boxes.
These two small boxes and a bigger one that contains the laser. We're going to start with the smallest of all of them, that I assume will contain the AC1 camera. And the first thing we find inside are some cardboard sheets with a white sticker on it, together with a dotted white surface that I think we'll need to calibrate the camera afterwards. Next, we have some instructions to set it up, that as you can see, are in full color. Then we find kind of an extensible arm that will hold the camera in place, together with some cables and the camera itself that come inside this bag. Then we find the measuring tape and a ball head, kind of what you will find on a camera tripod. Let's have a closer look. Finally, we'll find the clamp that will attach the camera to the laser frame or the table. We'll see. And I think that was the last component of the AC1 camera from ATOMSTACK, guys.
Now that we have finished unboxing the first box, let's go for the second one.
So starting with the second box, this time we find two user manuals on top of it. One for the Maker R1 rotary jack and one for the R2 roller. Then we'll find some cables and tools. And here we have the jack itself. As you can see, the build quality is insane. It's built out of heavy metal. Then we find some more plastic attachments, yet another one, a caliper, some accessories for the jack, and here we have a bunch of plastic extensions for the jack. Here we have another accessory that I think is useful to engrave, for example, a wine glass. Finally, we'll find a bubble level, another measuring tape that I think is the same model as the first one, and at the very bottom, the R2 roller that again feels a very premium product that together with the R1 jack
make the ultimate pair of high-quality accessories that every laser owner should have.
Finally, jumping to the last box, the first we find is a metal sheet to protect your table. And underneath the foam, we'll find some paperwork, the Laser Engraver user manual, as you can see in full color. Then some instructions for the air assist. And finally, a manual for the app. Having a look at the components, here we have a metallic bracket that I have no idea of what we will use it for. A blue USB cable, an HDMI cable that I guess is for the touchscreen. Next, we'll find what looks like the brain of the machine, which as you can see has all the connectors and buttons here at the top. Then a cool pair of protective glasses.
Wow!
Next, some of the profiles of this frame of the machine that are properly wrapped and protected as you can see. Here's one side, and the second one, that has a ruler printed on it. Next, we find what looks like the X-axis bridge that comes pre-assembled as you can see. Then, the air compressor, which as you can see, looks pretty cool. It definitely has a high quality look to it. We'll see how it actually performs later on. Here we have what looks like the Wi-Fi antenna tip that has probably fallen from its spot, and I'm going to quickly insert it in place. Then we have the LCD screen that is very well finished. And then we find the bag that has, as you can see, some sample materials such as wood and acrylic. And then all the bolts and parts for the build properly tagged. Good job, ATOMSTACK. Some more tools, and finally some zip ties for the cable management, as well as a microSD to USB adapter with a microSD card inserted. Next we'll find the air assist cable that has a very satisfying touch, the power cord, pretty standard, a brush, a cable splitter for the power connection, and a big power supply that, as I can read, outputs 144 watts. Then we find what looks like the legs of the machine, all built in metal. And here at the very bottom of the foam, we'll find the laser head itself. It's the most powerful laser yet in our fleet, since it outputs 33 to 36 watts of laser power. Finally, we'll find the front part of the structure, as well as the rear part that has the name of the model on it. ATOMSTACK Maker A30 Pro. And now yes, we are done with the unboxing of these incredible machines.
Now that we have unboxed all the components and we have a giant pile of components situation going on, let's quickly assemble everything together because I can't wait to see how it works.
A According to the instructions, we'll start with the frame that we'll place just like that, and we'll use the bolt in the back step 1 to put everything together. As always, we'll first install all of them and then tighten all the four corners. Next, we'll pick up the feet of the machine, the electronics box, and the X-axis gantry that we'll insert from top of the machine just like that. It's then where we'll take the step 2 bag of bolts and we'll assemble everything together just like that. The first bolt goes here, and here the second one. Once in, we'll tighten all of them, and we'll repeat this in the other three corners of the machine. At the bottom left corner, we'll install the electronics box that will also actuate as a foot for the machine, and we'll install it in place just like that. Now, according to step 3, we'll pick up the GT2 belts and the bolts and nuts from the back, and we'll install them in place. To start, we'll have to fit it in between the wheels here at the ends of the X-axis. Once we have the belt inserted, we'll pull from it so I can reach both sides equally. And finally, we'll install the T-nuts, pressing the belt down from each of the ends. So that's the first end, and then we'll repeat the same in the other one. As you can see, this side works perfectly, and the belt keeps its tension all time. Once this side is finished, we'll jump to the other one, where we'll repeat the same steps. First, passing the belt through the wheels and extending the both ends equally. Then insert one of the end nuts in one of the ends. Finally, we'll cut the excess of the belt in all four corners, and we'll be ready to jump to the next step. That will be to put the plastic covers on each of the ends of the square profiles just like that. Next step will be to put this calibration piece right here, and then we'll connect the HDMI cable to the LCD screen, that will attach magnetically here as you can see. Then I'm gonna cut this quality control tag, because we're going to attach the laser head already in place. For that we'll slide it from top, and once in place we'll tighten the thumb screw just like that.
At this point, we will only need to make all the necessary cable connections, and we'll be ready to test the machine. So let's go for it!
So after cutting the zip tie holding the cables, we'll extend them all over the machine just like that. And the first cable we're going to plug is here at the beginning. It is the Y-axis end stop. We'll continue with the Y-axis motor, then the X-axis end stop that is right here. And right next, on top of the extruder, we'll plug the X-axis motor. And last but not least, the laser head module, that is quite tricky to plug in. Next, as we always do, we'll use the included zip ties to manage all the cabling. Cut the excess with the flash cutters, and we'll finally be ready to test the machine. As you can see, all the axes can properly move, and all the cables are as tidy as they can. Next, we're going to set the protective metallic sheet in place here, and we're going to use one of the provided wooden cards to test the machine. The process of leveling the laser head is very easy. We'll just set the adapter in place, we'll bring the laser head down till it touches, and we'll then remove the leveling adapter. At this point, we'll be ready to test the machine. So we'll first plug the power supply to the extension cord. Then, we'll use the cable splitter we saw before to connect one of the ends here at the laser machine and the other one to the compressor. Once done, I'm going to test the compressor, and as you can see, it works. But we'll need to use the rubber pipe to make it work as it should. So we'll connect one of the ends here at the compressor and the other one here at the laser head that has all the conductions inside ready to work. Next step will be to plug in the microSD card that came with the machine just like that, and we can already turn the machine on by pressing the power button. As you can see, the machine shows the option carve, and it has two sample files that we're gonna use to test the machine. After loading one of them, we'll press on frame, so we can set the correct spot of the wood as you can see in this closer shot. Right after, we can start engraving the job.
I'm gonna leave you with a time lapse of the process, and I will see you at the end.
As you can see, the engraving job ended up beautifully, and here you can see the final result. The resolution is very high, you can even differentiate all these small symbols in the border. Next, I'm going to test the new AC1 camera, so we'll screw it to the ball head just like that, and next we'll attach it to the extension arm. We'll then use the clamp to attach it to the frame of the machine just like that, and finally we'll insert the arm on top just like that, so the camera gets more or less centered on top of the machine. As you can see, that would be more or less its ideal position. Now that we have made all the alignment according to the instructions, using Lightburn, we can directly place our engraving or cutting jobs on top of the surface, what will be very useful to align small objects.
We're going to make another test with the machine, having placed the file with the help of the camera, and as you can see, it works pretty well, and the job has been much easier. As the engraving job is being made, I'm going to leave you with a couple cool shots of the machine, and I will see you in a moment. As you can see, guys, we got a pretty damn good result with the engraving job. Having a closer look, as you can see, the quality is just amazing. And that was only at 20% power and 1000 mm per minute speed. The quality of the engraving is overall very good. Now I have started a cutting job with the power set to 100% and the speed set to 150 mm per minute. I wasn't sure if the laser was actually going through, since there was no smog or anything. But after the work finished, I discovered that the ATOMSTACK MAKER A30 PRO did a really good cutting job, getting an absolute perfect thin cut, very clean on both sides of the wood, in a single pass in this 5mm plywood. We need to cut the video here, since it's getting too long, and we have not enough time to keep talking about the other two accessories provided by ATOMSTACK. We'll do a dedicated video soon, showing to you how they actually perform. And not much else to say, guys. Remember that we'll find the link to buy the ATOMSTACK A30 PRO down in the description. Now go and make sure you're subscribed to the channel, consider supporting my work on Patreon as all these amazing people does, and as always, see you in the next video.